All right, so good morning. Oh my gosh, I'm getting back to singing again. It's kind of, it's a decadent procedure because I am feeling like, oh my gosh, I'm maybe loud in the neighborhood, but nobody is complaining so far, so I'll be happy with that. But away from me, I actually wanted to talk and discuss of my mother. I've been going over many boxes today and clearing them out, and I'm like, well, you know, what is the deal? What was her big input into my life and into even the lives of others? Okay, so I will go through straight up. She was very, very intelligent woman, very well read, and no matter how much of her life was kept in austerity of predicament, she still did not give up that fashion that she is quite intelligible, and this is still a plausible world to fix and repair. So she was quite a politician at heart. All right. So here, and a humorous one. So here's like, she leaves me all these magazines here of things and work to do. Now I've got to go to Belize, and I have to help an animal, and I'm like, well, these are papers that have been written back way, I don't know, 1980s or something. But here it says Nirvana no more, and in essence, that right there is just pretty much the humor of it. And when I'm getting into Nirvana no more, even that moment of reading this paper, of going through this particular paper and reading it and keeping that cherished a connection with the written word and the human, is about my mother. This is about the intelligence of reading, absolutely reading, you know, enjoying that moment with the author, enjoying that luxuriant state of understand, you know, that intelligence moment, you know. So when we say people are well read or whatever, you know, are they still, you know? So we're in this compass of are they still well read? You know what I'm saying? Yeah, Nirvana no more. I mean, I believe this is probably about some habitat. You know, this was back in what? Oh, the year is 1994, this particular magazine. So I'm probably going to be I'm tossing these all out today. And yet I feel like, oh my gosh, an expirant to absolute, you know, maybe these were moments of greatness for Ecology. Just the fact that she was there as a human being on this planet collecting it and being interested. You know, and look at this funny little animal. His tail, his limbs, his arms, you know, these types of things. Her collects, you know, her collections. And this animal apparently is a spider monkey. And it was necessary for her to purchase this piece of paper, yes, from a tree, I know, a source, but it was necessary for the learned experience of the you know, getting it all together, getting the, what do we call it, the paperwork, because it's true, you know, you're going off on these eco tours or whatever. There are a few of you that do it. You actually go off, and that's your eco holiday. You go down to some place, some rainforest somewhere. And here it is, it's saying, how much is this species worth? You know what I mean? This is my mother, you know. She hits hard. She hits hard on me. All throughout my life, this is her energy. Her energy is that. And there it is, this particular owl. I mean, that's a beautiful. That's a beautiful mother to have. So yeah. Anyway, missing her today for sure. My gosh. Yeah, I mean, it was a type of a relationship that it was about nature, ecology, the repair, the fix. And here it is here, you know, we have the wolves, you know, we have all these issues, don't we? We have all these issues, you know, and they're just there. And I'm like, well, have they gone? Have they gone away? And in, you know, are they? They're still going on. They're still going on. And here's one here. This is quite an interesting one. It's a rare squirrel here. He is he loses his final court battle. Now, he was in court, this particular little squirrel. They took him to court, and I guess they did not want him around any longer. And I imagine it was about the trees that he was living in, and they were going to take the trees. So I haven't read the whole court battle, but he lost it. And so this little cutie black squirrel, I don't know what happened to him. I don't know if he's still existing or not. But yeah, that's Mary's energy. That's where Mary was, you know. Her life was all about this. And it's a luxury. It is an absolute luxury to delve in to any of this ecology. It's like, you know, when you think of the manual worker state, they're not doing this. They are just not doing this. It's almost as if it's something for a specific class group that just has the time. You know, if you have the time in your life, instead of watching your little soap operas or whatever, what are you really doing? If you have the money, the time, the precious day-to-day existence of just being a lazy person and not really doing anything, you know, is there that hello, aren't you supposed to wake up to aren't you supposed to wake up to do it, to go out there and be part of these particulars, you know, and even help save that little black squirrel, even though he lost the case. Even try to help, you know what I'm saying? So here we have Lizard in the Jungle. Oh my gosh, she's just funny here. And now I'm like, now what do I do with these things? I guess, you know, toss them away here. And it's just very clever here. His iguanas are the favorite food of the people that live in Central America. They're just a favorite food. They love to eat them. So here is this iguana, this massive iguana that's piped up a tree. And she has it printed out here, and it's a delicious food to the people in the Central America. See, this is all brand new and learned. So she is a teacher. You understand? It's all brand new and learned to you. Maybe to me also. I didn't read everything. Oh my gosh. Living in the tropics. Yeah, and so she goes on and on and on with these types of cute things. But then, you know, people can be annoying along this strain. It's almost like they can be too much. So there's the lizard in the jungle. Munch, munch, you know. Now everybody knows they're edible. Now, oh my goodness, now she has the cows. I don't even know what is going on with the cows. I didn't need actually any direction from her, which is interesting, because I got already so much from my place of birth, the location, you know, near Berkeley, near the you know, the timeline, I'll call it the timeline of that breakout, the ecology breakout, you know. It's really what it was about, you know, the ecological breakout about the world and the planet and the save right there in Berkeley. So I didn't need this paperwork from my mother, ever. But, a teacher. She's a teacher in fashion. The fashion of the earth. And you never know what's in the water. Oh my gosh, and then I have to hear this. So here's the cow saying, and you never know what's in the water. So I have this, like, what do you call it? It's hanging over the head. Every day, the everyday thing, you know, what's in the water, you know, because of this cow. Well, no, this is brand new. She brought this brand new to me today, and yeah, but I've always had that in my head also. However, not everybody does, you know. And it says there at the top, beef is a favorite food of the Americans living in the USA. And I wonder, the ones who leave the USA, they just stop eating the beef. I imagine another food becomes a favorite. So draw the straws on the brain there that go, well, yeah, I guess so. Yeah, so it's tough, you know. She was so smart, so intelligent, that she was difficult, very difficult woman with all of her intelligence. It's not an easy time. It's not an easy time when you're waking up a planet and you have all this communication. We're talking ecology. It's not an easy time. Because you have a lot of old, you know, you have a lot of the old beliefs, a lot of the old hates. I think I lost the video. Yeah.